Hi everybody, thanks so much for joining me for this video. If you can't tell by my voice, I am still battling through my cold, like I'm sure many of you are this time of year. So if you are dealing with a cold like me, I hope you feel better soon. But I did want to get this video out there because I've done a lot of talking just here and there about these Wet n Wild 8 color palettes. I've blogged with some pictures. I mentioned this in my More for Your Money makeup video, and I also have a tutorial using the more neutral of the three palettes. So you've heard a little bit about it here and there, but I feel like I owe everyone just a full-on review about, you know, what I think about the quality of these palettes. What has happened? Wet n Wild has come out with quite a few new eyeshadows. They have some new trios, and it's called Color Icon. And they've got some new trios, which you might have seen, with some real bright colors. But the thing that I think a lot of people were really anticipating were these eight color palettes. There's three of them, and one is called Comfort Zone. It's kind of like neutrals and olives. One is called Petal Pusher, and this is going to be your purple tone and kind of mauves and maroons. And then Blue Had Me at Hello is kind of your silvers, blacks, and blues. So you're getting eight colors in each palette, and each shade actually has a little imprinted label on it for where to use it. So like this says brow bone, eyelid, crease, and definer. So you can kind of see them if you look vertically. You know, if you're a little lost, you think eight colors, what do I do? Well, you could kind of see it as basically two quads in one palette. You're getting the same amount of each shade. I don't like how sometimes you'll get certain brands and they will give you a big swath of a light shade and then just a little bit of the darkest shade, and you know, kind of making that assumption for how you're going to use this palette. I like that you're getting full amount of each color. Even though this is a large palette, they're giving you the same amount you would get if it was in a trio. So I think that's really nice. And then if you turn it over on the back, it gives you sort of a formula, I guess, on how to get a sweet look, a flirty look, dramatic look, or a wild look. So that's a little look there at the back, just to show you exactly how to apply it, and then it goes through and says which colors to put together. So that's really helpful if you're new to combining a bunch of different shades. That's sort of my overall feeling about these palettes, is that I think they're very pigmented. Some of the dark shades, you really have to be careful with them. If you're just, you know, popping your eyeshadow brush on there and going straight to your eye, I would really recommend giving it a little tap. Or sometimes what I even do, like I have this little mirror that I sometimes kind of look down into when I'm doing my eye makeup, and I will sometimes just tap my brush after I've got the product on it, tap it on the mirror. It just dusts off some excess, and then I can, you know, really get it where I want it on my eye. It's not something I'm going to complain about, because I feel like many drugstore eyeshadows do force you to work a little harder sometimes to pick up the product. Although, as a whole, I think drugstore shadows are really upping their game, and I think Wet n Wild is kind of leading the pack with palettes like this. And also, they are $4.99. I guess that may vary by location, but around $5 for eight, you know, regular size shadows for what this line puts out, I think is really fantastic. So just want to talk a little bit about each one individually, and you'll see as I talk, you know, some pictures up close of the palette and some swatches too. But Comfort Zone, for those who love neutrals, you're going to really enjoy this palette. Actually, from this palette today, see that pretty shade that says Eyelid? That's one of my favorites. It's actually kind of a goldeny peach, and I've got that all over my lid. And then I took the shade labeled Crease right below it, and I put that in my crease, and a little bit of the brow bone shade right up in here. And I kind of drew that eyelid color. I kind of pulled it up a little ways, so it kind of all really blends together. So I think this is so fun to be able to kind of go between the sides as well, because when I was doing my look in the olive tutorial, and I'm sorry I sound so nasal, guys, it's probably annoying, but when I did my look with the olive colors, you know, I went over here, but then I took the highlight from that side. So really use your own creativity. The swatch-wise, these all swatch very easily. Something you should keep in mind is that all of these have some degree of a shimmer, or at least a pearly quality. For example, this shade that's labeled Crease, you know, you look at it and it doesn't seem, you know, super shimmery, but it does give off kind of that pearly metallic look. And then there are a couple of shades, like this one that says Definer and this one that says Crease, that actually do have a noticeable sparkle in them. So you're not getting any matte colors. This Definer shade, if you're familiar with Too Faced Cosmetics, it reminds me a lot of Label Whore because it gives off that bluish brownish two-tone look, which is really interesting. So I think olives are a great way to kind of deviate from the typical brown spectrum and give yourself a still neutral eye, but something that's really pretty. And I think that that light green is just stunning there. So love this palette. Neutral lovers will enjoy this. Just keep in mind you're not getting any mattes there, which kind of surprised me because that was the direction they were heading with palettes like these. Remember these Color Icon palettes where it was half matte, half shimmer? But I must say those shimmery shades give off a lot of pigmentation, and you'll notice that. When I did my swatches on my hand, I didn't use any primer there. So I wanted you to see just what these gave off, and I literally took my finger from the palette and then put it on my hand like that. So you're really seeing the true ability or the capability of these products. The set called Petal Pusher, this is something that fans of the plums and the purples are going to enjoy. I must say, in my group of swatches of these, the lighter shades on the upper left-hand side here, I didn't feel like they gave off a whole lot of color. And those are probably the most matte shades of the group. I don't know that they're entire, I mean, compared to everything else, they do appear to be matte. And they're just a little bit softer. It's not bad to have a couple soft shades in a palette that's otherwise kind of intense. I like these deep kind of periwinkle purples here. This shade is great. Something I did, I took this shade, which is kind of a dupe for MAC Beauty Marked right here, which is a shade that I currently am loving, and I think I might have it handy here. Yes, I do. I'll hold that up for you so you can be impressed by how similar they really are. Just a second here. There's Beauty Marked, and there is the shade I'm saying is a dupe right here. So you can see they both have that same kind of burgundy purple reflective quality. So if you've really been wanting to try Beauty Marked, this shade is very much like it. But once again, they give off a lot of color with just barely any. You know, you just kind of have to retrain yourself. If you are a longtime drugstore shadow user, train yourself to only really tap your brush into these products just lightly. But a look that I went for, back to my original story I was trying to tell, I like took this pinkish brow bone shade, put that all over the lid, started to blend this color on the outer part of my lid, and then kind of took it up into the crease a bit and also used that purpley shade on the left, and it was so pretty. I've had a lot of fun with this palette. I don't feel like the swatches did it quite as much justice. This shade called Eyelid, another one of those two-tone shades that they've thrown in that can look peachy pink or purple depending on how the light hits it. So, I mean, you look at it in there, you might think, oh, that's just peach or whatever, but it does have, as I tilt it back, you can see how it changes. So I love that they've thrown in some shades that you just don't see every day, and it's nice to have that nice kind of charcoal color there as well. The kit that I thought would be, I think at just first glance, I thought this will be the one that I probably don't use as much. And I did buy these all from Walgreens, and I just really wanted to be able to try them all, you know, but I kind of thought from this one, you know, this might be the one I don't use as much. However, you've got to really think about what you're getting here. I know your eye kind of goes to the turquoise and the blues, and you think, man, there's the blue palette, you know, but in all honesty, you're getting so many other things. I'll use this as my little pointer here. You're getting a great metallic silver. That's a great all-purpose shade. Above it, a pearly white. And then a matte black. That, yes, that is matte. And then another black here that has some sparkle to it. You've got a knockout navy blue here with the sparkle in that is not silver. It is like a navy blue sparkle. So think deep, rich blue shadow with a hint of blue sparkle. It's gorgeous. And then, you know, here's kind of your more colorful blue and your teal. So these swatched so beautifully. I was really nuts about the way these turned out. And I mean, so I think as you look at this palette, you might think, I'm not a blue person, but really you've got a lot of good basics in here as well. That pretty much sums up my review for these palettes. I love them, but something I do think you need to be aware of is that between all of these palettes, you're getting maybe 3 matte colors, and they're kind of on the verge as well, but you know, you're getting a couple in the Petal Pusher one and then a matte black in this one. Your neutral palette is all shimmery, so I just think you should be aware of that if you are a fan of matte shadows. However, they have done a terrific job of making all of the shimmery shadows in these palettes really pop and really look great. So I think this would be a great little, you know, gift item if maybe you're starting to think about Valentine's Day, or maybe even for your daughter or a best friend or somebody to pop in a little Valentine's Day basket or something. These are really fun and so affordable for the amount of shadows you get. I think you're going to realize once you start using it just how many options you have. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this review of these products, and let me know if you like them, if you've tried them yet, and what you like to do with them. So thanks again for watching, guys. Have a great day.